Welcome back, Netcode-Hub family. Today we are diving into something every developer needs to know. That is upgrading your .NET project to the latest and graded version of .NET 9. Why is this important? Because, you know, staying up to date means better performance, new features, improved security, and ensuring your application remains future-proof. So whether you are on .NET 7, or 8, or even older version, this upgrade will unlock a whole new level of possibilities for your project. So stick with me as I guide you step by step to seamlessly transition your project to .NET 9 without breaking anything. Let's make upgrading super simple and stress-free. Let's go. I have an old project, .NET 7, created in here, and that is a build tracker. And you know, .NET 7, I use Blazor server application. And you know, in .NET 8, .NET 9, this has changed drastically, right? Now, we don't have a separate Blazor server. You can have web app interactive server. So it means if I want to upgrade my project to .NET 8 or 9, it means I need to use the interactive server, render mode. Great. Now that we have defined this, how do we go about it? First of all, I've run the project. So this is the project. It's .NET 7. It's just a build tracker, and it keeps track with the same fusion. And you can see from this issue that I'm having here means I need to integrate the license key. I am actually not focused on concerned with this because I want to show you how you can upgrade this, but not how to use this. Okay. So let's say this app is running over here. Now this app is in .NET 7. So let's see how we can make it work. When I go to solution, you know, this is .NET 7, how it worked. We have our pages, our host.cs, HTML file. If you've used .NET 7 before, you know what I'm talking about. And here we are using an SQLite DB. Aside from that, we have some stuff in here. Okay, now you see from the properties in here, I'm using .NET 7.0, and that is the version I used there. And also these are the packages with their various versions. All right, so in order to transform this, to move this or upgrade this project to .NET 9, you know, .NET 9 or 8 has a lot of features which .NET 7 doesn't. So if you want to upgrade it straight from here, you might face an issue. You're going to struggle a lot. So my advice for you is to create a new template with the same project name. Then you can make up here and paste. Since everything is in the folder structured, you can just move it in and out. I'm going to show you how you can do that simply. So first of all, we're going to create a project with the same Blazor server build tracker. Okay, this time around it's going to be .NET 9. So you can see that from here, I am choosing framework of .NET 9.0. That is what I want to move. That's the latest and graded version. And we see I'm using interactive server because I have Blazor server application. So once I have this project created, you know, let me just refold. Great. So when you look at this, you can see that we are having our structure here for .NET 9, which comes with the interactivities and all those stuffs. If you check the folder structure, you can see it is quite different. So if you want to integrate this, if you want to maintain this and now change this, unless you integrate all this stuff in it, it's very cumbersome and a lot of work. That's the reason why you need to make it in this format. Now this is what you're going to do. Now you see from here, we have in our data folder, which contains all our models and services and etc. So don't waste time at all. Let's go and grab this and dump it in our project, because we don't want to change anything. We want to maintain the concept, and just that the target framework is what we need. So we have it over here. So this contains all the database configuration, our services and other stuff. Okay, we can also add migration, because since it's part of this, we can also add that. Now when it comes to the pages, we are no more having this host. So when you go to the host, that is where we have our same fusion and all the CSS stuff in it. So I have two links files, so I'm going to grab them. Then I'll go to my component, to my app.razor, and in here drop them. So you can see that there's slight change in here as compared to .NET 8 even. So you can see from here, instead of using the same stuff 9.9, we have this asset, and that's why we can specify your static files. So if you want to upgrade from .NET 8, it's quite the same. But you know, from .NET 8, it's quite similar. Just that there are some few tasks that you have to do. But well, if you don't want to have any issue, you can follow this, create a new project in the new version and try to copy and paste or move all your files to the new solution. Okay, now if I, so in the solution over here, pages, I want to delete everything from here. And then I have a component. So if you have your component in your folder, you can just drag and drop them. So I'll just move this here. And we are no more having index, so the name is quite important. We now have home.razor, although it is the same route as homepage. Good. So after we are done with this, we now go to our import. And now in our import, we are using same facing components. So I'm going to grab from here. Then since I have the same import here, I'm going to paste it. Start from there. The next thing to do is, you can see when you check your app settings, you're having connection strength. So don't forget, you must also move that to your connections over here, app settings. Now, after we're done with this, you can see we have a database. So we need to also move it. Since we have an SQLite attached file, I can also move this DB to this. So you know, to add migration, I have it over there. Now, the next thing to do here is we have our packages, so our dependencies. How would you do it? Let's save this project. And here I'm going to unload this. So maybe you need to upgrade this to .NET 9, right? You can update the packages by well. I have them, so this is what I need to do. I'll just go to my .NET 7 and I have all this, so I can just grab this now in here, just paste it. So instead of .NET 7, you can make it .NET 9.0. So you can upgrade it from here, or you can upgrade it from the package manager console. Anyone will work. If you know the version that you want to upgrade to, you can do that. Now that is what matters most. For the same feature, if you want to have a new feature, you can decide to upgrade it, but if you decide not to do it, or it's still going to work. This is the most important thing, because you need to align with the Microsoft.NET version. So okay, so we have 9.0 as our target framework is good. Now let's save this, and I'm going to reload project with dependencies, which you get these packages restored in the version of .NET 9. If it doesn't, then I need to rebuild this project to make sure everything is intact. Now let's check and see, do we have any other again? No, we don't. Let's go to our program.cs, and in here we need to include our database. So you can see we have our service registered, our DB context created, and also sync fusion. So we need to grab these three services. We go to our program and add the same thing. This should come from using sync fusion packages, and now there, these dependencies have been resolved. Good. Now let's see, what again do we have? None. So we are good. Now let's go and build this project to see everything works, then we can run this. So that is it, succeeded as you can see from here. Now if you are not having .NET 9 SDK installed, how would you do it? You need to just go in there and install or update your Visual Studio. So you know, there are many ways of updating Visual Studio. We can use the Visual Studio installer. Now this installer is part of your source, so you can just, it's an app installed as soon as you have Visual Studio. So you can just go in that and get that installed, and you can see from here you can update it. So as soon as you see an update, it tells you that well, you can move to .NET 9.0, going to be installed automatically. Or you can also go to, I think, is it help? Then do we have update? Check for update, exactly. So this one. Now this will check for updates. Then you can just click on it automatically and update it. That is when you're using Visual Studio. If you are not using Visual Studio, it means you need to install the .NET 9 SDK. Where are you going to get it? Let's pull our browser and check it out. So you can see from here that we're having an up to date. So you can also update it in case you have an update to make. You can click on it and get it updated. And also, if you're using either Mac or Linux and you want to update it when you're not using Visual Studio, it means you cannot use all these features. And in this case, you can go to the site and now type in .NET 9 SDK. So this link just leads you to this place. And in here, you can, I'll put the link in the video description. And in here, you can just download based on your OS. So after you are done, you can just go in there and now install. Now, when you're done installing, you can just put in any of your console. So here, let me just put my PowerShell. And now with this, we can decide, or we can type in to see or get a list of SDKs which have been installed on your machine. So all SDKs are going to be listed up in there, and in case you have .NET 9 in it, It tells you that, wow, yeah, I do have it, and you can go ahead and do the same. How do you do it? .NET, then --list SDKs. Now this, you see from here, I am having, check it well, I'm having 8.0 and a 9.0. So I have this 9.0. So after you're done installing this SDK manually, you're gonna have this. And as soon as you get it, it means you have your SDK installed. And in this case, if you're done with that, and once you have our new project so created over here, you can see we're having a .NET 9 as well. Okay. So make sure that all the target framework that you have in your project, in case you have any extra library added, you must also change the target framework to 9.0, and boom, and that is all. So let's go and see, run this app and check it out. So this .NET 9, let's hit it and see. And that is it. You can see that we have the same version also running, and this in .NET 9. So we have upgraded our application from .NET 7 straight to .NET 8. If you want to upgrade from to .NET 8, it's quite same. From .NET 8 to .NET 9, it is quite same, although with .NET 9, with few changes made in .NET 8. So you can decide to look at these changes and now do it, or you can create a new template in that and now drag and drop all your component that you have created in that. I think that one is that's the simplest one. Yeah, in that, and you're going to have same thing as well. All right, so I think we forgot to do this. I think we did not add our nav manager. Our nav menu. So to fix that quickly, yeah, I will just open this. I want to make sure it works well before we close this. So you can see from here, now there's slight change in here comparing the .NET 7 nav menu with .NET 9. You can see all these have been removed, have been added to the CSLJS file. So we want to grab only this one and then go to our projects. When you go to solution and check our layouts, you see from here we have in our nav menu, you see we have a simple one. It has been streamlined, so I can move this and I replace it with this. Quite simple. I can now run this and let's check this out. Oh yeah, so now it is fixed now, and we can click on the build, and it will lead us to our build component that we created. So you can see that, wow, we have everything set. All right, so that is it for this video, folks. We've seen how we can move our project, which is in .NET 7 or 9, and even older version to .NET 9. That's the current and graded version that we have so far. Wow, so I'll be doing another video for web API. In case you have a web API, for that, you don't need to create a new template. No, you don't need to do that. I'll show you the simplest way to do that in the web API. So stay tuned for that video to be ready soon, and hopefully you're gonna enjoy it as you enjoy this as well. So in case you're okay with this and you've learned something, kindly hit on the like button and also subscribe to this if you haven't done that, to receive and to get more .NET content and as it's powerful informative content as well. I'll catch you up again. Until then, take care.